Welcome to Algebra SAT Bootcamp. We are going to start a series of videos targeting the main domains of the SAT test that is coming in August for you, the students, or for you, the teacher, or for you, a math lower. Bootcamp Algebra. We're going to start with one question, median level of difficulty for you. Let's see it. If I answer this question in the SAT, I go straight and solve the equation. Distributive property, and distributive property here is going to be 6x minus 18 minus 11. And on this side will be 4x minus 12 plus 6. Combine like terms here, 6x minus 29. And right here is 4x minus 6. Cancel the x with the lowest coefficient, minus 4x is going to be 2x minus 29. Equals negative 6. So I add 29 here and I add 29 here. Cancel this out. I have 2x equal 29 minus 6, which is 23, and then divided by 2. So the x value is 23 divided by 2, but this is now the answer. So the answer is x minus 3. So it's 23 over 2 minus 3. So common denominator here is 2. You multiply by 2 and by 2, and you have 23 over 2 minus 6 over 2. So the answer here is 17 over 2, which is B. This is the fastest way? Maybe yes, maybe no. But this is the idea. If you have an equation in the SAT, go and solve the equation. But usually, in the SAT, the answer for that equation is related to the question. It's not the answer itself. So be ready for that type of questions in the SAT. When you get here and you get 23 over 2, the students immediately see, oh, 23 over 2. This is not the answer. The answer is 23 over 2 minus 3. And that's why you get to 17 over 2. Really important, this type of questions in the bootcamp. Ready for the next bootcamp algebra question? Let's do it. Want to see another approach of this question? Okay. You can factor right here 2 from this parenthesis. And you can have 3 times 2, factoring out 2, x minus 3. Okay. Minus 11. And 4 x minus 3 plus 6. Okay, I just factor out the 2. I have here 6, let me use a different color. 6 x minus 3 minus 11 equal 4 x minus 3 plus 6. Let's combine like terms, because if you move 4 x minus 3 over here, you're going to have, let me use a different color, 6 x minus 3 minus 4 x minus 3. We have a common expression, common factors here, minus 11 equals 6, okay? 6x is minus 3, minus 4x is minus 3, is a total of 2x minus 3 minus 11 equals 6. So then you solve this equation normally, so 6 plus 11, 17. Here we have x minus 3 equals 17 over 2. Remember that, because we divide by 2. And then we have right here x equals 17 over 2 plus 3. No? Plus 3 over 1. So we do exactly the same, 17 over 2. The common denominator is 2, so multiply by 2 the whole fraction. So you're going to have 6 over 2. And now 17 plus 6 is 23 over 2. And you get to the same x value, and you can replace the x value right here. Subtract 3, and you're going to get the same answer, 17 over 2. This is another approach. And when we are training, it's important to see different approaches, no? And this is one of them. Factor out the 2. Let me summarize. Factor out the 2. Which is the same as dividing by 2. 2x divided by 2 is x, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. And now I notice here that I have like terms. 6x minus 3, 4x is minus 3, and 4 times x minus 3. So I move it to the left, subtracting, and so I have 6 of the same minus 4 of the same is 2 of the same. And cancel the 11, 6 plus 11, 17. Divide by 2, 17 divided by 2, and finally plus 3. Common denominator 2, multiplied by 2, the second fraction. So it's 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 1 is 2. We have like denominators, so we can add the top, 17 plus 6, 23 over 2. X value is 23 over 2. If we go back to the first approach, the x value is 23 over 2. We replace it with the xx, and we subtract x minus 3, which is the same as 23 over 2 minus 3. 23 over 2 minus 3 will give you 17 over 2. Very interesting. But also, I want you to check this beautiful mathematics here. X minus 3 is 17 over 2. So you don't need that extra step. You don't even need to find the x value if you check carefully the mathematics here. You already have the answer right here, and that will be save you time for the SAT. So you have exactly how much is x minus 3, which is your question. Your question is, how much is x minus 3? And you have it here, how much is x minus 3? So let me highlight that because it's so beautiful. So beautiful that this x minus 3 is right here doing this approach. And with this approach, you save time. With this approach, you're ready to score high in the SAT. Next question, please. Remember that the SAT is about time. It's about the velocity in which you are going to answer the question. But not only that, you have to answer the question sometimes in less than a minute or sometimes in less than 30 seconds. So my advice is that you do it right, but be smart. Practice the SAT format questions. This is really important. The way they use to ask the questions. So let's do this second question from the algebra, that the level of difficulty is median. Let's see it. Let's do question number 2 of this bootcamp. 2x plus 16 is equal 8 times x plus 8. If the given equation, in the given equation, a is a constant. If the equation has infinitely many solutions, what is the value of a? You know, as soon as you see the a right here, let me use it highlighted. As soon as you see the a right here, you know that we have to find the value of a. So don't waste time. Look at the other important elements. The equation has infinite solutions. So what is that situation in algebra? That situation in algebra is simple. Something that has infinite solution is something like 2x plus 1 equals 2x plus 1. This is when we have infinite solutions. So basically, this is the prompt in order to answer the question. So that A must be a number that when you substitute that number here and you apply the distributive property, you get 2x plus 16. Very simple. Okay, what is that number? That number is 2, because if I replace the a by 2, so a is equal to 2, so I'm going to have the factorization of this I. So if you factor this I, let me do it, use a different color, you can factor out the 2. If you factor out the 2, you get x plus 8. So immediately you know that the a value here is 2. Let me use again the highlighters. So look at over here, Look at over here. Look at over here. Look at over here. Look at over here. So you only need to factor this out in order to find the value of A, because this is the prompt. Okay, this is the prompt. Okay, many solutions, infinite many solutions. If you know this algebra skill or this algebra information, let's name it that way, you know how to handle this in seconds. I can tell you, in less than 20 seconds or more, in less than 10 seconds. And make that connection with factorization. We need to factor this left side, and immediately we get this expression here, and the A is immediately 2. This is a medium level of difficulty. So look at the examples that we have done today, the two questions. They belong to the same category: algebra, linear equations, and medium level difficulty. Our next video will be question number 3 and question number 4, the same topic, the same domain, algebra, but hard questions. So we are going to increase the level of difficulty. But I recommend to practice questions like 1 and 2 today. So I don't want to extend more the first video of the bootcamp series about SAT math, but I want you to practice. If you like the video, please give us a like and share that. And thank you for watching. I see you in the next video. Thank you.